Hey everyone! Today I will show you how to create a minimal style website using Slides framework. In this video, I will explain how to work with the Slides app, how to use the manual, how to use the examples, and how to edit the code. In less than 30 minutes, we'll create a cool website with good design and animation. Start by opening the Slides app. Here, I will start to build my website by choosing from Designs and Effects. The first thing I will do is switch the background option to white, because I want a minimalistic website and don't need background images and effects. I choose the desired slides one by one. I'm trying to choose different types of slides to show you how to work with each of them. For animation, I will select the chain effect. I think this effect is perfect for my website style. I will ignore the menus and navigation, and will leave the default style of the website, because it is perfect for what I want to build. Let's see the preview of the actual template, to be sure I have finished the slide selection, and I can export them to my local computer. Okay, the animations look good, and all the selected slides are here. But I think I will make changes to the slides order, and will swap one slide with another one. I want to remove slide 82. For this, I open the selected slide and remove it. And I will select another one, slide 87. The order of slides is not good now, and I will change the slide location by dragging and dropping them right in the Slides app. Let's preview the result. This is better, because the slides are ordered logically, and I can make additional changes to the order later. Now, let's go back and export the template to my local computer. Find the downloaded zip file and export it right here. All files are located in this folder. Here are the first step files, manual files, CSS, HTML files, and more. Open the index.html file in your favorite code editor. You can see the code is well organized. Open index.html in a browser. This is our website with all the selected slides and effects. Website images are located in the Assets folder. So let's start to customize our template. I will open the first slide image in Photoshop and change this image with another one. In this tutorial, I will use the images and text from one of the projects from Kickstarter called Neuro. Take a look at this minimal watch. It's very cool. Okay, let's start with template customization. I have saved a few images from Neuro Watch. I will copy these images to Photoshop and adjust it to the size of the previous image. Refresh the page, and here is the new image. I will remove this play button because I don't need the video function for this image. In the code, I will remove the part of the code related to Vimeo and the video thumbnail class. Refresh the page, and it's just what I want to see. Now, I want to remove the link to the image also. Go back to the code editor and remove these classes. The result is good. Let's change the text on the page. I can copy, paste the text because I have prepared it from the Neuro Watch campaign. The result is good, but I want to fix the description, because the word yet is orphan and is not good. So, let's remove it. Now, it is perfect. Let's go to the next slide. I will change this image and remove the open effect. Open the image in the same way in Photoshop. Remember, you can change images how you want. I just show my workflow here. You might do this another way. Drag and drop the new image and adjust it to the size. Save the image, let's see. Okay, I don't like how the watches are positioned. I will adjust this in Photoshop. Yes, now is better. Next, I want to remove this effect. Open the code editor, and let's see where to change the code. Here is the data action, and I will remove the zoom effect and link. Refresh the page. Good, this is what I want. Now, I will change the text and move forward the video in order to not lose the time for these simple and repetitive changes. Now, in the same way, refresh the page and check the changes. Good. For the next slide, I prepared something new. I will use a jiff image instead of a static image. For this, I will copy and paste the prepared jiff image to img folder. Let's rename it and open the code editor. Here, we'll change the file extension to jiff, remove the video thumbnail code, save the file and check the result. I think the image is too big, so I will remove the shadow. Back to code editor, and remove the rounded shadow and paste the height and width of the jiff image right here. I will make the image smaller. Refresh the page. The result is not very good. It seems we should remove a style. Open the code editor, and here we'll remove the wide class. And also, I will change the height and width size to 500 pixels. Change the text of this slide and refresh the page to check the final result. Yes, now this is good. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay, for this slide, I will use the slides manual, because I want to use a background image here. Open the code editor. Remove the code from Vimeo from the previous slide, and change the text on slide 4. In this slide, I will use the information about the Red Dot Design Award, because this watch was awarded in 2010 for the best concept. I need a background image here. Open the slides manual. Find the background section and copy this part of the code. Open the code editor and paste it before the section. Now, copy and paste the background image to background folder located in img folder. Change the name of the image directly in the code and save. I will refresh the page and check the result. The page looks good. The background has a perfect fit for the typography, colors, and grid. Scroll down to see the next slide. In this slide, we'll change the text and icons, and you will learn how to change icons without image editing. Open the code editor and edit all the text. I will move forward because it's a repetitive part of our tutorial. Save the file to see the live result. The text is changed and fits well. Now for the most interesting part, how to change the icons. For this purpose, I will use the manual. Open the manual and scroll to material icons. You'll find detailed information about how to use the material icons in slides. Open the Material Icons website, which includes all the icons supported by slides. Each icon has a name, so we'll use this name to change icons on our slide. I have selected a few names of icons, and I will change them directly in the code. Material icons have a dedicated class, so it's easy to find them. Just change the name with your desired icon name. Refresh the page to see the new icons. In this style, you can change any icon you want. More details are available in our documentation page. Scroll down for next slide. In this slide, I will change the video and thumbnail. Open the code editor and find the code. I will change the text and remove the blue button. To change the video, you need to copy and paste the ID of the video from Vimeo. Insert the ID here, and that's it. We have changed the video. Next, I will change the thumbnail. Do this in the same way as before. Open the image in Photoshop. Resize it to fit the previous image and save the file. Go back to the browser and refresh the page to check the changed file. Here it is. Let's play the video. Very good. In the next slide, we'll create a small gallery with three images. Open the code editor and start making the changes. First, I will edit the text and remove the unnecessary part of the content from our design. Also, I will remove the second row of images. Open the folder with images and remove the unnecessary images. Now it's time to change the existing three images and insert ours there. I will use the same editing process in Photoshop as we have previously used. I will move forward the video because the process is exactly the same as before. Save all the changes and open the browser to check. The images are here. I think the gallery looks good, and all works well. Now, let's go to the next slide. Here, I want to mention the creators of this watch. I open the code editor and remove this text and change the next one. Also, I want to add a background image. For this, I copy the same code as before. And I change the title of the image, save the document, and refresh the browser. Here is the result. It looks good, but I will change the font to bold. For this, open the code editor and add the class bold. Let's see the result. Great! You can leave the default style of the font if you like. Our website is almost ready, but I want to add a slide with a video background. I want to create a spectacular intro to my website because now it's a little bit static. This slide will be the first. Open the Slides app, and in the footer of the page you will find examples. Click here. Copy and use the ready-made code for different services, tools, or a new functionality for your website. I will use the Vimeo background for this example. Here is a preview. Go back and copy the HTML code, or you can download it. I have copied it and will paste to our code before the first slide. Here is the step-by-step instruction on how to use this example and integrate it on your website. First, we have to add this script to the head section of our code. Just cut the code and paste to head. Second, insert this code custom.js file. Copy the code and open the custom.js file located in JS folder. And the last step is to cut this CSS code and put it to the custom.css file located in CSS folder. Okay. Clean the unused code now, and let's change the text and video in this example. Open your video on Vimeo and copy the ID of the video. Now paste it right here in the code. And change the remaining text to the name of the watch and description. Save the file. Open the browser and refresh the website. The first slide is here, and is attractive, with a nice video background and a short description of what about this website is about. I want one more small change. I will make the title of the watch bold. For this, I have to change the class of font, the light parameter, to be bold. Refresh the website. I think it's better now. After watching this video, you should be ready to use slides to create a website fast. For an advanced customization, just use our detailed documentation page and ready-made examples, which will help you integrate different services and options into your website. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you again soon!